Whether times are tough or times are good, I think every business needs a consistent and stable rhythm of offers. And I wonder what yours is. Now, you don't know what I'm talking about. Let me explain. An offer is basically an announcement or invitation to your audience to work with you, to buy your product, to hire you for your services, to join your program or event. It's a call to action that is related to an exchange of money with your with what you offer in your business. So you have got to have a stable rhythm where you are making these calls to actions and invitations, even when times are really challenging and unstable, which is right now during the recording of this. We are going through the coronavirus pandemic, and a lot of businesses are, you know, unfortunately, the retail businesses, many of them are shutting down. So, but many of you who are watching this don't run a retail business. You run a business that where you can offer something online, which I have been doing for more than a decade, and my business has not had any change, barely any change since the pandemic began. It's still it's the same because I offer everything online. So I really, really recommend that to starting today, if you don't already have a stable rhythm of offers, that you start one today. Okay, so let me explain what my rhythm is, and then you could see how you want to create yours. By the way, I do want to mention that I'm testing out the Zoom virtual backgrounds. So I hope you enjoy this. This is not actually my living room, but I welcome you into this virtual living room with snow outside. Wherever, think about your favorite place that snows. That's where we are. And we've got the little warm fire here, so you're welcome to join me. And let's sit around and talk about your rhythm of offers. So, you know, if you've been following my content at all, you know I talk a lot about having a consistent rhythm of content, right? Creating and distributing content. And I obviously will keep talking about that. I do it myself. This video is an example of my consistent rhythm of content. I say that it's kind of like the heartbeat of one's business. And well, you know what? I want to say that if content is like the heartbeat of your business, then having consistent rhythm of offers is like having a consistent breathing pattern, breathing in, breathing out, or maybe better yet to say a consistent rhythm of eating and sleeping. So it's that important. If you are, so many of you I've seen, there's people that I work with, people in my audience, I notice that you basically just talk about your services when you are inspired to, or when you really need clients. Then you go, hey, everyone, I need clients right now. And so if that's the case where you only talk about what your product and services are when you need money, then you're going to always go through this up and down, what people call the feast and famine cycle in business. It's like when you have clients, things are good. You're making enough money. When you don't have clients, you're like struggling. Maybe you have to get credit, or it's, you've got to be consistent with your disciplines of authentic business. I call them disciplines of authentic business. There are seven of them. And that's another blog post. You can Google seven disciplines of authentic business to read all about it. But here in this one, I just want to talk about your discipline of having an ongoing, regular series of offers. Okay, so I promised you I would tell you mine. Mine is very simple. Every single month, I have a launch of some kind. It's a light, I call it a light launch. It's like a light lunch, except it's a light launch every single month. And you can see what my launches are. If you go, you can literally see how I launch, okay? Here's how I launch. You can go see it for yourself. Go to my Facebook business page, facebook.com/GeorgeCalCommunity. I have two Facebook pages, okay? I have three Facebook pages. Make sure you go to the correct one. facebook.com/GeorgeCalCommunity, okay? My Facebook business page, if you look at what I post on Wednesdays, every single Wednesday I post something related to the current launch that I'm doing. So you can see how I do it, and you can copy whatever I do. You can copy or borrow it for your own use, customize it for yourself. I always say that all my content is open source, all my offerings, all my invitations, everything I do is open source. You're always welcome to borrow it, learn from it, use it for yourself, emulate it and however you want. Okay. So that's what I do every Wednesday. I have some kind of post. Maybe it's a Facebook event. Maybe it's a text only post. Maybe it's a video or whatever it is about the current launch. Actually, sometimes I do a video about the current launch on Tuesdays as well as Wednesdays. So, but that's once a month I do a video on Tuesday about the current launch. But usually I only do something every Wednesday on my Facebook page about my current launch. So go and check it out. It's basically one call to action each week, okay, to my Facebook community. And then I also email my my launch list. I have a special email list for people who want to hear about my launches. And by the way, I do notice that the virtual background is kind of flickering every now and then. So I'm going to change it to this one. I don't think flickers. Let's see if it's better. So join me now on a beach. It's kind of a windy day, unfortunately. So you might not want to go surfing unless you're really good at it. Hopefully you can relax with me here for another few minutes. Okay, so I do a monthly light launch. And when I say light, I really do mean it. It's very simple. I don't stress out over it. I basically make a Wednesday post, and then I email my email list, and then I might ask my clients to help me share it. That's it. That's all I do for the launch. So it's very, very doable, and I recommend you do the same. In terms of a ratio between how much you invite people to buy your stuff versus how much you're just giving, blessing them with content, free content, I always talk about a ratio of 1 out of every 5 to 10. So for every 5 to 10 free content pieces that you put out there, make 1 invitation or announcement asking them to buy something. Again, make 1 invitation, call to action post. Hey, buy this for every 5 to 10 content posts. Now, why 5 to 10? Well, if your audience is colder, maybe you should do more like 1 out of 10. If your audience is warmer, you could do 1 out of every 5. I do about 1 out of every 7 because I make a Wednesday post, right? Asking you to buy something. And it could be either the current, I'm creating a new course or I'm selling an old course. So I make a post every day on my Facebook business page. I sometimes schedule it so it goes out, but there's some content that goes out every day. So therefore, my rhythm is about 1 out of every 7. So what about you? What is your rhythm of calls to action, rhythm of offers? Like I said, I have a monthly launch of some kind of course, new or old. I recommend that you do the same. Will you please consider this? Please consider launching a new course or an old course every month. It doesn't have to be complicated. Like I say, just making a social media post once a week and then emailing your list once or maybe twice a month about the current launch. That's what I do. If you join my launch list, I call it, basically the email list where I sell you things. Do you want to see how I sell? Join my email list where I sell you things. It's georgecow.com/invitations. georgecow.com/invitations with an S at the end is my launch list. It's you'll join. Once you join, in fact, even before you join, you can see literally all my emails going back months and months of how I do it. So watch how I do it. Go to georgecow.com/invitations. There's a link there to read all my past emails where I sell stuff. So you can borrow as much of that as you want. So I email the list 2 to 3 times a month, that list. Of course, my content list, I email every week with my free content. And at the bottom, I have some invitation. So please consider having a monthly launch. Keep it simple. The reason why I recommend a monthly launch is because then, get this, you get 12 opportunities to test per year. Let me say that again. Every year, you only have a limited number of opportunities to test what your audience will buy from you. And many of you are wasting your opportunities because you only ask for clients whenever you are desperate for them or when you need them. And so I don't know how often that is. Maybe that's only 4 times a year or six times a year. I do it 12 times a year. And because I do it so consistently, all of you, my audience, you're used to it. You know, oh, George always has some kind of launch every month, and you're still with me. So you're still here. One of my posts, I've talked about how we should not be afraid of losing people, because the people who are our ideal clients or ideal audience will always stick with us through thick and thin. So you have to get to some kind of consistent rhythm of inviting them into your business. Not, they don't always have to buy from you. You don't make them feel bad, but you at least need to invite so that they need to be reminded. You need to be reminded every month of what I sell. Otherwise, you think I just make videos for fun, right? But that's true of your audience too. Your audience thinks that you just make videos for fun. You're just a hobby, or you write blog posts for fun. You have some other money coming in and you just do this stuff for fun. That's what our audience assumes until we step out and say, hey, by the way, I this is a business and I would love for you to buy my product. I think that you'll enjoy it. I think you'll really benefit from it. And you're supporting my business also, right? Or please hire me for the service, because I think those are really helpful. Those of you who are struggling with this, or who are wanting to achieve this, or who are wanting to heal from this, please hire me for this, because that's what I offer. I love doing this, and you'll be supporting my business, and you'll be getting the healing, or getting the transformation, or getting the problem solved. That's what I do. You see, so making an offer is not bad. It's basically being in a closer relationship with your audience. That's all it is. So if you have an offer that is something they want, right, at a price that they can afford, that they can see is a really good price for what you offer, then they'll buy. And so that's why you need to keep testing. Hey, this month it's this, will you buy it? Is this something interesting for you? Oh, it's not, it's okay. I'll have another offer next month and maybe that'll be more interesting for you. You see, so give yourself more opportunities to test with your audience, experiment, so that you'll know what the world, what your audience wants to pay you for. So what we're always trying to get to, I call it the calling of our business. Would you like to find the calling of your, what is your calling? The calling of your business is that intersection. Imagine two circles, right? Your passion, your skills, and what the world wants to pay you for. What is your passion and skills and what the world wants to pay you for? There is an intersection there, and you're trying to figure out what that intersection is. And that's what frequent offers, tests, allows you to figure out that intersection so that you can find that sacred intersection between your passion and skills and what the world will gladly pay you for, because they want it from you. They need it from you. So I hope that this is encouraging. Please, starting today, start a rhythm of offers. Okay, I have a blog post associated with this video if you want to read more and kind of look at it step by step. But start a rhythm of offers so that you can give yourself those opportunities to find the calling, the purpose of your business. All right. I hope this is helpful. I'm George Cao, authentic business coach. I always enjoy hearing from you. And if you enjoyed this video, I think you'll like my other videos about authentic marketing, building a stable and growing business that supports your life's calling. So that's what I love talking about. I wish you well, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thank you for those of you who are joining me for this Facebook Live. And in fact, I'm going to take a moment now, just taking a minute to see if anybody has made any live comments. And those of you watching this, please go ahead and comment below. I'd love to see if this made a difference for you, if this made sense for you, if it helped you at all. And let me go ahead and go and see if there's any, while you're waiting for me, go ahead and comment below if you'd like. Let's see if this is working. Okay. Well, thank you so much for joining me, Jennifer and Brian, Tanya, April, Jeff. Thank you so much. So I will see you all in the next video. Until then, go and create your stable rhythm of offers, particularly in unstable times. Unstable times need stable people. So be one of those stable people for your audience. All right. Be well. Take care.